What are the stages of CLL?
So in the United States, the RISE staging system is what we use to stage chronic lymphocytic leukemia. There's RISE stage 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. RISE stage 0 is when you have excess of the lymphocytes, but you don't have any other problems that you can discern. In RISE stage 1, you develop lymph gland swelling. In RISE stage 2, you develop spleen and liver enlargement. In RISE stage 3, you can get to be anemic. In RISE stage 4, your platelets go down as well.
How do the stages correlate in terms of treatment and prognosis?
A lot of times patients will ask me, oh, do I have metastases? No, it's different because the disease is always everywhere, so it's a little bit different than staging other cancers. But staging is still important because staging guides us on what we're going to do. So going back to the example of the breast cancer, sometimes stage one breast cancer, you might just do surgery. Stage two, you may do surgery and some radiation. So staging guides us and not necessarily means where it is, but are ways to define the extent of the disease or the burden of the disease. So we do have staging in CLL, and this staging mainly takes into consideration if you have lymph nodes enlarged, if you have your spleen enlarged, or if you have a little bit more involvement of the disease causing problems in your bone marrow with low hemoglobin, low platelets. So the staging can guide us on what you expect from the disease. But more than the staging today, what we really use are genetic features. There are molecular changes that are mutations, that are specific findings that guide us on how we expect the disease to behave. So in the end, all of these give us information of what to expect, but most of them are not really indication for treatment. We still define if you're going to treat or not based on the presence of the symptoms, those features that tell us the disease is causing trouble. That's usually how I tell you. If your disease is causing trouble, we'll take care of it. If it's not causing trouble, just sitting there, we won't do anything. And the staging may guide us on what to expect, but it's very different than the staging that we have for the other cancers because the disease already starts off being in your blood.
At what stage is treatment started?
For chronic lymphocytic leukemia, we generally, as I said, often don't even need to treat patients, and observation alone may be possible for a period of time. The reason to treat would be if you start developing RISE stage 2 or greater disease and have got enlarged spleen, enlarged liver, or if your hemoglobin and platelet count declines. If you're under a wait and watch approach, if your white count is doubling in less than 6 months, that would be a reason to treat. Patients who are symptomatic with fevers, night sweats, weight loss, or any other symptoms would also be worthy of considering treatment. The staging system is prognostic, so patients who have higher RISE stages do have a shorter time to progression, and they do have a more limited lifespan.
Does your risk stratification impact the stages of CLL?
So the stages in CLL, these basic staging, will tell us a little bit about risk. So patients that present with more advanced stage means that they have a greater burden of disease, probably they'll require therapy faster or they'll require therapy right away, and they may have problems earlier on. So stages do have a relationship with that, but what really today really guides us beyond the staging are really these genetic molecular markers. So there are two big categories. One is it's called immunoglobulin heavy gene, whether it's mutated or not. So the immunoglobulin heavy gene is a way that we know how mature or immature the cell is. And the idea is if it's a very immature cell, it tends to be a little bit of a more aggressive disease. So we use that to kind of guide us on what to expect from therapy. And then there are specific gene mutations or changes in chromosomes, like deletions in certain parts of chromosomes or mutations in certain genes. So deletions of the small arm of chromosome 17, so 17p deletion, or the mutation on the gene TP53. So those are some of important mutations that guide us on what to expect from the disease.
At the moment, the most commonly used risk stratification system does not include the genetic information, but we know it is prognostic, and in the future, it will probably be part of some new classification system for prognosis that will be adopted.